Aussie tennis legend and one of the greatest players of all time. And after years of dominating on the court these days, Pat Cash is also playing a vital role in the commentary box. He'll be calling all the best plays at the French Open. He'll be playing and coaching as well. Live from Paris this morning, please welcome Pat Cash. Good morning, or should we say bonsoir?
Bonsoir.
Now, Pat, it's been 3 decades since you won Wimbledon. Well, that was on a grass court. Clay is what is played on at the French Open. How tricky is that for the players?
Yeah, look, it's not for the Europeans because they grow up on the the clay, but of course for the Aussies, we don't typically grow up on it. In Melbourne, we do a little bit. I grew up on playing on the Anticar courts, the slippery courts there, but it's they tend to have a bit of an advantage. The South Americans play a lot on the clay as well. So the Aussies tend to take a few years to get used to it, though Sam Stosur did a great job. Of course, she'd been in the final before, and she hardly played on it growing up. So, look, you can adapt to it. It just takes, it's like anything. It's slippery, you've got to move, it's different tactics. Yeah. The conditions in Paris can be anything from beautifully hot and fast conditions to rainy and sloggy, so it's it really is a challenge. The French Open is, and of course the rallies go on and on, so it tends to really sap your endurance. It's certainly one of the toughest events.
Yeah, man. I grew up playing on a clay court, and all I remember was just the sweeping, just the endless, endless sweeping. Now, Pat, the French Open begins this weekend, as we said, and Serena Williams is set to come back as a 36-year-old mother. Controversially, I think she was actually unseeded, just as Margaret Court did. Do you think she can win? I mean, she won the Australian Open when she was pregnant, for God's sake.
Yeah, look, I think it's probably going to be a tough for Serena this time round. She hasn't played a lot of matches. The French Open typically don't seed a player. They go strictly by the rankings all the way down. Wimbledon mix them up. They can do whatever they want. They usually have a format to it. But I think Serena, it won't be long before she's regarded as one of the top seeds and will get seedings. But she's got to play a few matches. She's only played, I don't know, maybe two or three matches since having the baby. So it's over a year. So she probably doesn't really warrant it, but it won't be very long. And if she gets a few matches under her belt, we know how she can play.
Yeah. I saw her at the royal wedding last weekend, and I'm pretty sure she picked up a bit of a spin on the dance floor at the reception. So that could have been good training. But Nick Kyrgios is also set for the French Open, but he's been battling an elbow injury. Do you think he'll be okay? And could he even win Wimbledon like you did?
Well, the worst thing for an athlete is to be injured, and Nick's carrying a few injuries at the moment. His elbow, he's got a pretty good draw. So he's got a couple of players, probably two or three players there where he'd fancy himself to go through pretty easily, and he needs to do that. He doesn't want to get into a long match with his shoulders a bit sore. He's going to be in a bit of trouble. So if he gets through those first rounds, he's got a chance, but he's struggling to put together consistent wins this year because of the injury. It's not much difference in Wimbledon. Wimbledon is a lot of serving, and he has to get his body right. And it might be a time where he says, I need to take 2 months off and get it, or 3 months off and get it really right. And tennis, you just don't have that. You don't have off seasons. It's not like you can, have a pre-season training. Yeah. You have a matter of a month at the in December, and that's about it. So it's really tough to get an injury right when you're in the middle of the circuit.
And Pat, I was actually reading an old article about Nick Kyrgios just last night, and just about his incredible natural talent, his incredible flair. I think someone said he could practice for 15 minutes a day and still be in the top 20 in the world. And you, of course, yourself are an incredibly colourful player. You sent the royal box into hysterics after you climbed up the walls at Wimbledon. What do you make of Nick Kyrgios? Can you empathise with the sort of mindset or psychology he has, and do you think he'll be able to control those sort of furious emotions in him enough to make it to number one?
Well, it's really hard. I'm not sure Nick has got number one material because you need to be consistent the whole time. Mm. He will get more consistent. There's no doubts about it. He's a terrific player. But your number one is typically every single week you're performing. Nick's the ability to win a big title, whether it's US Open, Wimbledon, Australian Open. French Open's probably going to be a little bit tough for him, but he's got the ability to beat some big stars. But, you know, he has to get his body right. There's, you know, he has incredible talent. But I tell you what, there's a lot of good talented players out there. You know, there's some that are not quite as talented but work harder. Some are not, you know, some are mentally more focused than him. So it's just a really, really tough sport to be in. And Nick's, as I said to the kids at my tennis academy when they started, I said, congratulations, you've just picked the world's toughest sport to be successful at.
Yeah. Now, Pat, you've advocated for women to play five sets. Why is that?
Well, I think we should need to consider that, certainly towards the Grand Slams in the final when there's equal prize money and millions of dollars. I think during the tournament, the rest of the tournament, I think probably three sets is probably suitable. But I don't see why there's certainly the women are fit enough. They do it in every other sport, go the distance. And I think that sort of money, I think five sets is certainly something that should be considered. And I think it should be on the table anyway, something to discuss. I'd love to see Serena playing a five-set Wimbledon final. Who wouldn't want to see that?
Yeah, for sure.
Go, you know, nip and tuck at the end against Sharapova. Wouldn't that be awesome? Just think that these two rivals could battle it out and over a five-set match. I'd certainly play good money for that.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm with you.